Welcome back to STV Sports Channel. Lanka Premier League is coming now. Walton is on strike and Gunatilaka is 13 for 10. Lavitas has been scored 17 for no loss after 2.3 overs. A good start from Gladiators and a steady bowling from Stallions here. As in the talk, Safidi had said that there is a win here. So there will be a light swing early on, and during second innings there will be no swing on third, so easy for the batsmen to take on the wickets. So Fernando bowling the third over of the power play. Gladiators are now 17 for no loss, run rate of 6.80. Tisara Pereira, captain of Stallion, has been discussing with the bowler for the perfect delivery to take the wickets. A good short length delivery. Picked up at short third man area. The pitch conditions here are almost creating some much extra bounce considered to other pitches. The game is conducting in Mahinda Rajapaksa International Stadium, Hanan Kota. Shahid Afridi, captain of Gladiators, has won the toss and chose to bat first. Yes, there is no due in this match, so putting runs on board and chasing them will be easier for the Gladiators team. So nice leg cut delivery, picked up to the fine leg area. Gunatilaka has been well timed the ball. Using the pace of the ball to cut and to get the boundary. A perfect timed shot from Gunatilaka. So this partnership is crucial for Gladiators. During this partnership they should not lose any wickets to gain some momentum in this game. Good shots in delivery, quick single. So yesterday Colombo Kings won the match. A good coming 11. Stay tuned with the STV Sports Channel. Gladiators are 23 for no loss after 3 overs. Welcome back to STV Sports Channel. A good over for Stallions here. Glenn Oliver has been bowling his first over in this match. Not considered only a single run of two balls, so Walton is on strike now. The run rate has to be neatly picked up to 8 or 9 runs per over to gain the momentum in this power play. So Oliver to bowl his third ball of his over. So I think it's going to be a wicket here. Yes, it's got a top edge. So short third woodman has caught the catch here. So breakthrough created by Oliver here in for the Stallions team. So Walter is out for 4. A good comeback from the Stallions bowling. Pereira has made his captaincy here. So change the bowling options to create a breakthrough, and the chance has been created and it was perfectly utilized by Stallions team. A good comeback and a breakthrough for Stallions. So Gladiators lost his first wicket. Chadwick Walton 4 for 7. Azam Khan has came into the middle. Highest score of 88 versus Northern. So 22 matches has been played and a score of 430 runs. So one down Azam Khan. So it's things wide here. Yes, it's a wide delivery. Gunatilya Khan has been facing the Oliver Cook ball. So that extra bounce has been created the top edge of here. So Chadwick doesn't time the ball well, so loses his wicket. So breakthrough created and Kyle Abbott again, same short ball has been bowled, so easily pulled off to a 4 over the fine leg. Good batting and perfect timing from Gunatilaka. His second boundary consecutive. So Gladiators batsman has been creating a momentum here again, pushing off well that extra bounce ball towards the fine leg area and scored 4 runs for his team. Oliver has been punished there for his short ball. So what will be the comeback delivery? Yes, again a good length delivery. Again it has been hit to the 4 over the third man area. Good timing and easy slicing of the ball created the pace of the bat to clear the boundary here for 3.5 overs, 33 for 1. So good batting from Gladiators batsman, and Gunatilaka is being the best contributing his runs for his team. So final ball of the 4th over. Again a good length delivery, again slightly pushed towards the leg side which has been gone through the 4. So consecutive 3 4s in his over. So 37 for 1 after 4 overs. Good comeback by Gladiators after losing a wicket. So stay tuned with STV Sports Channel for more live cricket scores and live updates. again a white delivery from Khair Abbott. So pressure created due to the last hat-trick force from consecutive three deliveries. So pressure created on Stallions bowlers. Azam Khan over great inside edge but missed two stumps. No chance here created. This was dived and saved his wicket. Gunatilaka 5-3 for 1. A good bowler from Khair Abbott, 6 runs considered at 4 balls. So Gunatilaka is on strike, 28 of 17 balls, 43 for 1, so run rate of 9.56. So a good power play for Gladiators batsman till now. Around the wicket, good length delivery and a single. Almost the momentum has been created from the Gladiators batsman after the loss of a wicket, which creates a pressure on Stallions bowlers. So next to bat will be Radhakrishna and Shahid Afridi. So Afridi, a T20 wonderful batsman and all-rounder, captain of the Gladiators team. So fully packed offside field here. So five fielders on offside. Inside the circle, nice short length delivery which has been pulled off to the fine leg or the square leg, and a single. Till now 11 extras has been bowled, which is more normal to the other international teams. So 11 extras in 4.5 overs is almost the greatest score considered. Again a short length delivery which has been pushed to the mid wicket area. So a single now. Forty-six for 1 after 5 overs. So stay tuned with STV's Post Channel. Nacho has conceded almost 10 runs. Struggling, I think so. And come back to last four overs. Last 2 overs is struggling lately to pick the gaps and to convert into boundaries. So Lanka Premier League 2020. 5 teams, 1 winner. Jaffna Stallions vs Galle Gladiators, match number 2 in Mahinda Rajapaksa International Stadium, Agankota. So another equipment delivery has been slightly pushed towards the fine leg area. So singles has been converting here. So rotating the strike will create the momentum in the team, which makes the batsman busy in these overs. So last 3 balls of the power play, already runs has been came, but run rate of 8.73 will be good in this power play. But to change the momentum and shifting the gears towards the biggest total, this is not so easy. So again, ball beaten the batsman. So 2 balls to go to end the power play. Shai Gakudi has been sitting in the Gladiators dugout. The happy face. Almost a good power play for Gladiators batsman. After losing a wicket, they have been changing the momentum here. Yes, of course. Deliver to both his 5th ball. Again, a good length delivery has been easily timed and perfectly pulled off to the fine leg area to the fore. Good batting from Gunatilaka and poor bowling from Oliver to bowl the leg side. As a turn, fine leg fielder has been inside the circle. So easy for one batsman to pick the four. Slightly pushed the ball using the pace of the ball to convert the dot ball to a four. So good batting from Gladiators. 52 for 1 for 5.5 overs. So a quick single here. So power play has been completed with a good batting from Gunatilaka. 53 for 1 after no loss. Here to bowl the first over for his team, Tisara Ferreira. Gunatilaka on strike now. Power play has been ended, so 5 fielders have been placed outside the circle. He's hitting me here. 54.1 after 6.1 overs at a run rate of 8.76. So the partnership has been developing slowly. So in T20 cricket, the partnership is a more crucial one to create a big score on the board. So the role has been played by both the batsmen here, Asan Khan and Gunatilaka. So Asan Khan, he is playing like a defensive role, I think so. Gunatilaka has been striking the ball very well. He has said in the last overs that he has been struggling slightly, but he has been cleared easily for the boundaries. So captain's bowling innings here for Stallions. Good length from Tisara Pereira, creating the pressure on batsman now. Two dot balls consecutively. An experienced Sri Lankan bowler, captain of the Jaffna Stallions. So the experience speaks here with the line and length bowler needs to bowl too. So slightly high matters here, so in case of low cut delivery, it will be an LBW here. After quick struggles, takes a single. So power play has been very good for both the teams. Gladiators has been dominated, I think so, because 53 runs considered in the power play is a good one for the batting team. After loss of one wicket, they have not shifted any plans. So stick to the plans and creating the boundaries here. So good power play for Gladiators team. Fifth ball, lofted shot towards the square leg and ends with a single. So run rate of 8.20 almost keeps reducing. So Gunatilaka has been striking the ball well, but he needs to stay there till the end of 15th over to bring a triple digit score and to have a run rate of 9 or 10. Azam Khan lifted, I think, yeah, just missed. A good delivery from Tisara Pereira. Azam Khan came down the ground but misses. So 56 for 1 after 7 overs. Stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. But misses the ball. Hasaranga, good spinner for Stallions team. Both his first ball in this match, run rate of 7.81, reduced from 9.36 to 7.81 in 3 overs. So now need to shift the gears now. Another bad ball. So Gunatilaka is being 37 of 28 balls and Azam Khan 8 of 10 balls. So partnership is being developing here from 33 runs. Again, perfect full length delivery. Pushed towards the mid wicket area. Scored a single now. So the main role of a T20 batsman is to keep running between the wickets by clicking singles and not to create any dot balls. So the role has been played well by Gunatilaka here. So sixth has been placed for Asam Khan to pick up the early wickets for His team, Kusara Pera, has been well in his captaincy till now. So, long on and the mid wicket and lack of fielder has been placed for Azam Khan and the square leg fielder. So, third man has been bring inside. So, lock came down the ground and hit towards the long off area. Easy single. 58 for 1 after 7.4 overs. Need to create some attacking field set for Kumar Sinaga, but Kusara Pereira has been thinking up on the other plan. Again, a reverse sweep, bold. He has been pushed the ball towards his stumps. So, a poor shot played by Kumar Sinaga, but inexperience has been shown by him. So, a well full length delivery. Missed the stumps and he himself hit into the stumps. A poor batting from Gunakilagar now. A weak shot. He himself hit into the stumps, which has been created a trouble for Gladiators team. 58 runs of 2 loss now. Stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. STV Sports Channel again. Kusara Pereira came into the bowling attack. Rajapaksa came into the crease, first ball single. So Kusara Pereira has been executing his plans well. So reverse sweep shot timed perfectly, but missed it to the stumps. So again, lifted, gone into the air. I think so. It will be a superb sixer from Azam Khan. Uses the pace of the ball, slightly connected well, which creates a boundary for Gladiators team. The timing was perfect while playing this shot, as he was very confident while playing this shot. So 79 meters, 6 has been hit perfectly on long on area. So now the role has been changed to Azam Khan. He needs to shift his gears now. 66 for 2 after 8.2 overs. Oh, again a nick towards the third one area, which has been created a single only. So surprise bounce factor. He's playing a key role in this match.
Thank you.
of power play here. 9 overs completed of 68 runs for 2 wickets. A good leg cutter delivery. Saranga has been bowling well here now. Considered only just 4 runs. Again, came down the ground and pushed towards the cover region's dot ball. So, Tisara Perera has been setting an attacking field set for Hasan Khan to pick his wicket. So, projected score 150. So, lifted towards the air, one bounce to the fielder. So, single. Projected score will be 150 of 8 runs per over. So there is no due factor playing in this match, so second innings will be more crucial for the bowlers to pick early wickets. The big score need to be hit by the Gladiators batsman to chase down the misfield. So Shahid Afridi has been sitting in the dugout, padded up for the next batting. So a good one from Tisara Perera in series missed the stumps 75 for 2 after 10.3 overs at a run rate of 7.14. Rajapaksa has been hit 6 runs from 10 balls and Nazem Khan has been hit 20 runs for 16 balls. Perera all deliveries tonight has been almost a very short length of 64% and a length delivery of 36%. Doesn't bowl any slot balls to create chances for the batsman to hit for the boundaries. Again a short ball delivery hit the batsman's helmet and a dot ball here. Perera 2.3 overs considered just only of 15 runs. So run rate has been reducing to almost 7.03. Banuka Rajapaksa been struggling the short ball deliveries here. Need to shift gears from down to create the momentum on Ladier as batsman. Physio has been coming in to check the injury of Rajapaksa. So next live will be South Africa versus England first T20 matches at 9:30 PM. So to watch that live, please subscribe to our channel and keep updating by clicking the notification bell. So stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. For 2 after 10.4 overs. Sara Perera, a good picked up by the batsman towards the long on area, has been created a boundary midfield here. So, boundary for Rajapaksa after 2 consecutive dot balls. So, 7 runs considered till now and 1 ball to go. That's a good short length delivery which has been slightly pushed towards the long on area. Good effort but didn't complete the field here. Again good length delivery missed by the batsman. So 11 overs has been ended, 79 for 2 after the end of 11 overs with a run rate of 7.18. So do subscribe our channel and keep updating by clicking the notification bell icon. So next live will be at 9:30 PM, South Africa versus England, first T20 international match. So to keep updating the scores and the commentary, please do subscribe our channel and click the bell icon for the notification of the next live. Stay tuned to the STV Sports Channel. Just only 7 runs from 2 overs and picked up a crucial wicket. Again a slog sweep towards the catch in the mid wicket area. The perfect ball to take the wicket of Hazem Khan as he bowled in the full length delivery, which created a wicketing chance for Hazaranga. Tisara Perera has been placed the field perfectly for the ball and made the batsman to go for a big shot and get caught over the field. So a change has been created and the momentum has been dropped down by Stallions. So I think Shahid Afridi will be coming in as only 7 overs has been left. No, by any other batsman has been coming inside ahead of Afridi, which will be creating a momentum shift for the scores to bring up to a 150 plus. This ground will be a good one for the defending team. So new factor doesn't play in this match, so big score on the board will make the defending team to create a wicket, wicketing chances and win the match easily. So as the Gladiators has been struggling after the power play, as they have been scored 53 runs of 6 overs, and after this 11th over they have just only scored 79 runs. So Melinda Srivarthana has come into the crease, has a strike rate of 141. Atharanga, a good wicket taking bowler, has been creating a wicketing chance for Stallions here. Three balls bowled in this over, one dot ball and second ball is a wicket, perfect delivery and perfectly timed shot that plays towards the fielder. Azam Khan has been out of 20 runs of 18 balls. Adaranga has been bowling the line and length, critically safe for Azam Khan. So there is no any change in plans, so stick to the plans and bowling the same line and length towards Rajapaksa. Came down the ground and slightly pushed over the square leg, created just a single. Run rate has been dropped down to 6.85. So the Stallions has been picking the wickets crucially at the regular intervals, that makes the momentum drop down for the Gladiators team. Again came down the ground, another fielding, good fielding effort, the cover area. So over has been ended 81 for 3 after 12 overs. So do subscribe our channel. Next live will be at 9:30 PM, South Africa vs England, first T20 international match. So keep updating with live scores and live commentary. So stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. And hit the ball straight up to the bowler and created a boundary for his team. So 15 runs of 16 balls. Shoaib Malik has been bowling well now. 403 matches, took about 149 wickets. Has been a part-time bowler for many teams and created many wicketing chances for the respective teams. Round the wicket, both the bowler and keeper has been chasing the ball but created just a single. Run rate has been shifted slightly to 6.97 by hitting the 4 of the first ball. So Srivarthana is on strike now. So almost needed another 30 to 40 runs before completing a 15th over will be a good one for the Gladiators team. So then a good length delivery goes towards the cover region, 86 for 3. Almost 6 runs considered off first 3 balls. So came down the ground. So lofted shot from Rajapaksa, which has been hit straightly up to the bowler. Again came down the ground and hit for the lofted shot. Same area on towards the long on. Boundary has been created from Rajapaksa here. Same timing, same shot, but ball went to long on and long off. So almost need to change his plans. Shoaib Malik need to bowl some short deliveries to create wicket options. So again came down 3 meters from the stumps and hit to a 4. Again after hitting a 4, converting the singles will be a good batting partnership here. After every boundaries, hitting singles will be a good one for the batsman to keep his mind calm in the non-strikers end, which makes him to be settled in the ground. Again, Srivardhana has came down the ground, but the dot ball to end the over. 92 for 3 after 13 overs. Stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. From Stallions bowler Rajapaksa has been out for 21 runs. Captain Shahid Afridi came into the crease, so 7 overs left for him to create a big score on the board. So Shahid Afridi, an experienced Pakistan cricketer, all rounder, 320 matches, scored almost 4322 runs for his team. A good finisher for Pakistan. So came into the crease for Gladiators to pick some early runs and make his team reach a reasonable total. So first ball pushed towards a single. So Afridi is a dangerous batsman. Stallions need to take his wicket early on to make this game towards their side. So Lanka Premier League 2020 match number 2, Jaffna Stallions versus Delhi Gladiators. Coming from the start, the initial power phase has been dominated by Gladiators batsmen, and Gunatilaka has been scoring very well, almost 30 plus runs. So next, Shahzam Khan has been scoring a crucial wicket here. Srivardhana has been out in the Oliver's second delivery. So again a short ball. Short ball has been playing a crucial wicket taking balls here. Oliver has been bowling again a short ball which was hit well but strike to the hands in the square leg. So another wicket for Oliver and the Stallions team. Almost 5 gone, 93 for 5 after 33.3 overs. So a partnership is needed, a decent partnership is needed here for Gladiators to get to the reasonable total and for a defendable total. Yes, next live will be at 9:30 pm of South Africa versus England first T20 match in Cape Town, Newlands, Cape Town. So England has won the toss and chose to bowl first. The playing lines of England was Jos Buttler, Jason Roy, David Mattern, Bairstow, Ben Stokes, Aaron Morgan, Sam Curran, Tom Curran, Archer, Jordan and Adil Rashid. And for South Africa, Themba Bavuma, Quinton de Kock, Pat du Plessis, Rassie van der Dassen, Hendricks Claassen, Van Bijon, George Linde, Bjorn Hendricks, Kagi Sarabara, Lungi Ringdi and Tabrez Shamsi. So both the captains has been decided to buy field first, as the pitch condition has been supporting slightly for the chasing victory. So England has won the toss finally. So coming to the Lanka Premier League, great breakthrough has been created for the Stallions bowlers. So Jayasurya is now on strike, again pushed towards long arm mid arm single. So 94 for 5 after 13.5 overs. Run rate has been slightly came down to 6.8 again. Shahid Afridi need to create a momentum. Shehan Jayasurya, 79 matches has been played and hit almost 1,611 runs with a strike rate of 125.8. Has been in a good form in the recent days. So Shahid Afridi is facing second ball of his innings. Again slicked towards the square leg area, misfield but created just a single. So after the end of 14 overs, 95 for 5 Gladiators. Stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. Will be Hazaranga with 16 points and Azam Khan with 9.5 points. This point will be based on the end of 10th over. So Gladiators have been scoring some difficult runs here. Again a top edge missed by the fielder, and the umpire has been took his finger got for the LBW. So Shahid Afridi is asking for a DRS. So DRS has been taken, went for the third umpire for the decision, as I think for the ball to be somewhat slightly higher than the stumps, which will be umpire's call. A perfect ball by Hazaranga. There is no ball confusion. So slightly pitching on the foot length. So almost hitting above the knees. Maximum chances of missing the leg stump. Ultra edge has been checked now. There is no spikes in the ultra edge. So a clean delivery to check for the line and length. So maximum chances of missing the leg stumps, or it will be an umpire's call, which is also an out decision. Pitching outside of impact outside, so maximum chances review retained, and wickets also missing, so it's not out. Reverse the decision. So good DRS from Shahid Afridi, watching from non-striker scent, and suddenly as the umpire lift his hand, Afridi has been went for the DRS. The experience speaks now. Again a front foot shot. Dot ball again. The crucial one for the first batting lineup is the dot balls. Reduction of dot balls and creating more singles will be good for the first batting team to create a big score on the board. Many T20 teams have been making the same issue on their matches. Batting first and creating many dot balls will result into the pressure, and losing wickets will make them so almost keeping them busy by clicking just a singles in every ball will make the batsman busy and make the momentum towards the match. But here slice the ball. Afridi projected score 131 with a run rate of 6.54, and if the run rate has been shifted slightly to 8, will be almost 140 145. Timing has been missed by Shahid Afridi. They went on to the long run. Just a single. Hazaranga has been well bowled this over, considering just 12 runs of 4 overs, and crucial wickets has been taken by him. So completed his spell. 98 for 5 after 15 overs, coming to the death of the first innings. Let's see. Gladiators batsman has been creating a momentum or shift in the gears. So stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. Next live will be South Africa versus England in Cape Town. First T20 international match. So projected score for Gladiators will be 138 with a run rate of 8 runs per over, and 148 with a run rate of 10 runs per over. But if they considered same 6.53 runs and over, the projected score will be 131. So 150 plus will be the main defendable score in this pitch. So Gladiators need to shift the gears from here to make the defendable score. Shahid Afridi is on crease now, so he might create an impact in the batsman. Bernardo has been bowling his third over. Again a short ball delivery, maybe a wide. Umpire has not taken his answer. I think so, it's not fair delivery. Hazaranga, well bowled bowling figures today. Picked two crucial wickets of मुझे लगा रासम खान हु वर स्ट्राइकिंग द बॉल वेरी वेल सो सम कोचिंग एडवाइस हैज बीन गिवन टू रासम खान फॉर दैट शॉट has been come yes, so it has been given wide yes again same delivery but slightly pushed towards the fourth which beaten the keeper and went to the fourth so the activity has been decided to make the shifting gears now first ball wide and which has been reflected to the fourth now so 5 runs from one delivery 103 now. Another 5 deliveries left for Fernando. 103 for 5 after 15.1 overs. Second ball. Again a perfect line and length from Fernando. The left hander's curse has been playing a crucial role here. Good length, slightly off. Off jump creating a batsman's edge but Shahid Afridi slightly left the bat before so next live of South Africa versus England first T20 international match will be commenced soon within the 10 minutes so do subscribe our channel and keep the notification bell click long In a perfect delivery, pushed towards the third man area for four. Afridi well timed, uses the pace of the ball, slightly pushed towards the first tip area to create a boundary. So nine runs considered of three balls. Till now, it has been creating most expensive over. Keeper doesn't have chances to stop them. Uses the pace of the ball and slightly pushed over the first slip region. The most experienced cricketer of Pakistan, Shahid Afridi, has been on crease now. In the same length, Afridi tries to nick the ball over the first slip area but leaves. This is the batsman. The line and length bowled by Fernando was good. But slightly missed towards the off jump. Shahid Afridi, destructive batsman, middle order batsman. He has the ability to hit the six over the ropes in all areas. But till now, he doesn't hit any sixes. Over has been ending with just two balls to go 107 for 5 till now 9 runs has been come in this over fifth ball came down the ground and lofted towards the cover region for 4 so good batting from Shahid Afridi uses the base of the ball to keep pick the gaps and creating the boundaries for his team captain's innings has been started now almost 13 runs considered till now just one ball to go to end the over so came down the ground and slightly lofted towards the cover region last ball of 16th over when slightly pushed towards his leg side aiming for the double no just a single 112 for 5 after 16 overs. Stay tuned with the STV Sports Channel. after the parking. Traffic panel says that it is on strike now. Scored almost 113 of 5 wickets, Gladiators. Last over has been picked 3 fours and a single wide and a single run. Laughter shot from Shahid Afridi. I think it might be a catch, a drop chance, and went to the 4. I think so. Used the chance here for Hasaranga. Dropped the most crucial wicket of the team. This time the shot. Two fielders came mixed towards. Hasaranga has been game inside. And I think so it's going to be a 4. Gordon Bates has been checking the boundary lines for the runs. So almost it has been marked at Hasaranga's catch. Another player has been waiting for the catch. Unnecessarily, Hasaranga has been came into the play and made the catch ball. Considering 23 runs of 2.2 overs, Shahid Afridi has been hitting the ball hardly to clear the boundaries. Again, another short ball which has been hit perfectly, I think so. Yes, it has been cleared the boundary for the 6. Good shot from Shahid Afridi, as I said earlier, that Afridi is named for his destructive sixes. Like his first 6 in this over. Perfect time shot of the previous ball, he has made this time. So now, yep, got ready for this short ball delivery. Slightly moved towards offside and punched towards the leg side. Good shot from Shahid Afridi. Runs continued to now 11 runs. Came down the ground but missed the bag. 1.3 for 5 after 16.3 overs and 16.4 overs. Kyle Abbott, very expensive combination considered. Most a misfield. Jax misses. Has created Stallions into trouble. Next ball has been wet to the 6. Good ball. Again, a short ball delivery pushed towards the hind leg area for 6. Shahid Afridi is named for his respective sixes, so don't bother with his short ball delivery. He is very expert for the full shot and hook shots. The ball from Yorkers at the 10, which creates a pressure on the batsman, not the short ball, which came into the bat and slightly pushed it towards the hind leg, then towards the 6. Shahid Afridi, informed batsman. The crease now. Taking the last ball of the counting, 2 over. Till now, 17 runs has been conceded in 1 over and still 1 ball to go. Another wide delivery as he left the ball. Afridi has been showed his hands to the umpire for a wide, and umpire also given him. So pressure on the bowler, Kyle Abbott, 36 runs conceded in 2.5 overs. In this innings, almost 14 fours have been scored and 3 sixes have been hit. 2 sixes by Kyle Afridi and 1 by Aasim Khan. And ready for the offside shot, inside out. No wicketing chance, but stop the ball by getting towards the boundary. 2 runs have been got. Just a single. 131 for 5 after 17 overs. Once at a 1 point, Gladiators has been struggling to get up to 120, but now Sahil Afridi has been lifted the gears for Gladiators to bring up to 131 for 5 at 17 overs. Only 3 overs to go, so solidly the team has been shifting the gears towards 160, 130 plus. Stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. Another live of South Africa vs England. First T20 international match at Newlands Cape Town has been started. So do subscribe our channel and check our videos for live of South Africa vs England. The live scores and commentary has been given. Waiting over first ball, perfect shot by Jeremy, perfect wire cut for the 6. Shahid Afridi hitting his third 6 of his innings. Oliver bowling short ball, which will be punished by Afridi continually. So another lightly offside delivery. The power hit by Afridi shows the defense going and is batting. The captain snap has been perfectly given by Shahid Afridi here. 40 runs scored just off 18 balls. So started with a 6, pressure on the bowler. Second ball, full toss, slightly nicked over the fine leg for a 6. A good start for the Gladiators. 2 sixes consecutively, almost 12 runs conceded. Runs has been shifted to 143 for 5. Afridi is in good form now. Good toss, slightly nicked over, which went to the fine leg for 6. They are using the pace of the ball and timing perfectly. They make the side Afridi to clear the boundaries now. The good toss ball has been clicked over the fine leg. So waiting for the third delivery. Will it be a hat-trick sixes or not? Let's wait and see. Third ball, 2 consecutive sixes from Shahid Afridi, 46 of 19 balls. Another lofted shot from Shahid Afridi, I think so it will be a big hit. No, another 6 hat-trick sixes by Shahid Afridi. 50 for Shahid Afridi, 52 for 20 balls. A captain's knock from Gladiators team, which has been a strike rate of 160. 260. In 3 consecutive sixes in an over is almost a crucial thing for any batsman to do, but Shahid Afridi, an experienced respective batsman, has been clearly doing his job now. Shahid Afridi 3 sixes, conceding almost 30 runs in an over. He was not completed. 3 balls to go. 3 fours and 5 sixes in his innings. Shahid Afridi. Throw ball, good comeback from Oliver. Throw ball, beaten the batsman. Bowling some blockers will create a pressure on the batsman. The carrying ball will do the length delivery. Blocker length or wide off blocker length. Keeping the batsman staying inside the crease and making that sweep for a long shot. The bowling short links are full toss, will not create any change now. Again a short link delivery. Afridi has been pushed over the extra cover region for a 6. 4 sixes has been hit by Shahid Afridi, destructive batsman. The name tells the power he uses to hit for a 6s. It's ultimate now. almost 24 runs, the most expensive spell, I think so, for only 3 wickets, but 44 runs has been conceded. In this over, almost 24 runs, the strike rate of 263, Shahid Afridi has been hitting the ball outside the boundaries. So, one ball left. I think so, it's a wicket. Yes, umpire has been given. Slightly linked over the bat, Shahid Afridi's bat. He has been double-minded, I think so. Went for a shot, but missed it. Slightly hit it, and Shahid Afridi has been out for 58. Captain's knock has been entered in the over. 4 sixes, but 1 wicket. Costliest, but useful wicket has been taken at the end by Oliver. 4 wickets of 44 runs of 4 overs. So almost completing in all 4s. 4 sixes in an over. 4 wickets have been taken by Oliver. 44 runs have been given, considered. 4 overs have been completed. So stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. Next slide has been going on. South Africa vs England first T20 international match at Newlands, Cape Town. So for international matches, shift over to the next video, which will be streaming in our channel. So 155 for 6 after 18 overs, 2 hours to go. Stay tuned with the STV Sports Channel. So final over of the first innings, Stallions, Kyle Abbott, slightly expensive, 37 runs considered till now. So first ball is a dot ball. So previous over, last ball, a good short line delivery from Cesar Pereira, which created a top edge and a easy catch for a wicketkeeper. Balls on the ice and easy catch. So second ball of the last over, slow delivery, just a single. So Jay Surya is on strike, 167 for 7, last 4 balls of first innings. So almost till 15 overs, score was almost 97, but the last 3 overs, Shahid Afridi has been very destructive, striking almost every ball to a boundary, which created this score, a defendable score of 167. So 4 balls left for the innings to break. Another slow ball, Yarkar, good dead bowling. Another single. So any one of the batsmen need to take chance. Just 3 balls left. Just hitting 2 sixes will be given for 180. We'll be considering the defendable total. So let's wait and see. 3 balls left of first innings. Full toss missed by the batsman. Quick single. Byron. Kyle Abbott is bowling almost 99 kmph. Very slow delivery, which makes the batsman to struggle to clear the boundaries. So another 2 balls left. So 169 of 7, just 2 balls left. Slightly picked over the fine leg area towards the 6. Jayasurya has been hitting the ball well today. In the previous over has been hit a 6 in the first ball, and this over, fifth ball, has been hit towards the extra cover region for the 6. So good batting from Jayasurya, uses the pace of the ball and somewhat extra cover to hit the ball and clear the boundaries. So 175 has been come here. A boundary to complete will give 180, will be the target. Another Yarkar delivery, the keeper is landing here, run out. So 176 will be the target for Stallions to get and to win this match. A good batting performance from the Gladiators team, Shahid Afridi, Captain Snark, and Jay Surya, Gunatilaka, Azam Khan, the best bowling batting figures. And best bowling figures will be Hazaranga from Stallions. But all other bowlers are slightly expensive today. Kyle Abbott, 41 runs, 46 runs considered, and Oliver, 44 runs has been considered. These two will be the most crucial one for Gladiators to bring up the score for 175 of 8 after 20 overs at the red rate of 8.75. Last 5 overs has been very crucial for Gladiators to bring the total, to bring it to a defendable total. Shahid Afridi, well batting, a perfect batting and destructive batting, 4 sixes and over created a momentum and created a pressure on Stallions bowlers. So let's wait and see, do Stallions will pick this total and win this first match of Lanka Premier League 2020. So stay tuned with STV Sports Channel. Next live is going on of South Africa versus England first T20 international. So do subscribe our channel and keep supporting by your likes and shares. So stay tuned.
Mm-hmm.